Hey guys, it is Dani and welcome to this updated video on the tropics. And so in this video, we're going to be taking a look at our disturbances in vests 92L as well as 91E. And so we'll take a look at all the possibilities for how strong they might get and where we'll be affected, as well as conditions persistent across the basin. And so before I go into details, alright, so let us start off with Invest 92L. So that is our disturbance that is located off the Carolinas. And this disturbance is a non-tropical low pressure area out there. So it is possible that probably by the next day or so, it might develop some subtropical characteristics and probably become a brief subtropical storm. But after that time, conditions won't be so conducive. And so even though we're seeing that it is going to be staying off the coast of the Carolinas, it is likely to bring some inclement weather regardless. So areas might experience some heavy rainfall and gusty winds at times, especially persons that live in the eastern sections of the Carolinas and persons near the coast especially. So please be mindful of that, guys. And nothing major is really anticipated after that point. And so in terms of what our models are expecting for the potential intensity, we're seeing here that we have quite a bit available, and most agree that we won't have this achieving a tropical, or in this case subtropical, storm status. So again, it really has very limited time to get in shape, and we're going to see what happens after that point. But again, if you're the Carolinas, it is likely that you might experience some heavy rainfall from this, especially from the eastern sections. And so now let's go ahead and take a look at Invest 91E. So this is our disturbance over in the eastern Pacific. And so as of right now, we have the formation chance being increased once more. So the chance is now a high 90% for this to potentially develop into a tropical cyclone during the next couple of days, and also a high 80% chance through the next 48 hours. So it is almost certain that we will definitely have this developing into a tropical cyclone. So I wouldn't be surprised if by probably late tonight or tomorrow we have this becoming a depression. So fortunately, this is expected to parallel the coast of Mexico during the next couple of days when it is going to be making its way by. But there is that possibility that this thing here might curve into Mexico and make its way into the Gulf of Mexico. So that would be absolutely interesting to see play out, actually. And let's go ahead and see how it looks on satellites and what our models are anticipating from this. And so here we have, it's quite disorganized right now, but we have all that shower and thunderstorm activity being present, but it is not looking so well. We don't really see any circulation going on with this, but of course as time goes by, it is going to be looking a lot better. And so let's take a look at the model track guidance. And so we're seeing here that we have quite a bit of models available, and most are agreeing on that curve of the system making its way into portions of Mexico. And then once it does so, it is likely to rapidly weaken and dissipate, but the remnants might make their way over into the Gulf of Mexico. And so if conditions are going to be conducive there, especially in terms of the wind shear, then we will definitely see the system probably redeveloping in the Gulf. But again, things are still pretty far out, and we really have to wait and see what's going to be happening. It's kind of too early to tell what exactly the move is going to be that this system here makes. So in terms of what our models are expecting for the intensity, we're seeing here that we have quite a bit available, and majority expect that this will manage to achieve hurricane status. Some of them even taking it up to being a category 3, one showing a category 4. So once the conditions are just right, once we have that warm, the warm ocean waters, that favorable wind shear, as well as no dry air intrusion, then conditions you would say are considered perfect to accommodate a significant intensification of the system. And so hopefully it's going to be parallel in the coast of Mexico and not bringing any major impacts. But if it does make that curve inland, then impacts could be really, really bad, depending on the intensity of the storm at that time of landfall, if it is going to be making landfall. So we really have to wait and see what is going to be the eventual outcome of Invest 91. And so also, once we have it becoming a named storm, it is going to acquire the name Pamela, which is the next name to be used for the Eastern Pacific hurricane season. And so guys, now let's hop over back into the Atlantic and see how conditions are. And so first up is the wind shear map. So we have the different colors that indicate the favorability of the shear. We have the green, that means favorable, that is what accommodates tropical development. Yellow means neutral, and that is what really won't be too impactful on our systems. But red means unfavorable, and that is when we don't have a favorable environment for intensification of tropical systems or development. So we have that unfavorable shear extended across portions of the Gulf, the Caribbean, as well as the main development region. But things could get a little bit more conducive as time goes by, as we head on to the middle part of this month. And so in terms of the dry air now, the Saharan dust, we're seeing that we have the different colors that indicate how dense it is. We have the yellow, that means that there's less dust, so it's not so dense. But as we head to the dark orange, the red, that indicates a lot of dust, and that is the environment that prevents much intensification of systems, because dry air inhibits moisture, which is what tropical cyclones need. And so we're seeing here that we have that Saharan dust across the Caribbean dissipating. Some is affecting portions of eastern Jamaica right now, but shouldn't be anything too significant, just some hazy skies as a result of this. And other areas of the Caribbean, especially probably Puerto Rico, Hispaniola, and the Leeward Islands, are probably experiencing the same conditions, but nothing major is anticipated. So for the most part, the dust is not being very impactful right now, but it is out in the main development region, because once we have any disturbances making their way into a region of a lot of the Saharan dust, then moisture is going to be limited for it, and we will eventually have them dissipating. And so guys, now let's go ahead and take a look at what our GFS and Euro models are anticipating for the next couple of days, specifically for Invest 91E. Are we going to have it curving into the Gulf of Mexico, or is there more confidence? And so this is a map showing the isobars, and the isobars are lands of equal pressure, and when you see them being in a circular manner with the pressure below 1013 millibars, that is low pressure system and can be our tropical cyclone. So that is what we're looking for here. And so we're seeing that this is by Sunday the 10th of October, and you do have that 1002 millibar low off the Carolinas, that is Invest 92L, probably briefly developing into a subtropical cyclone. But over in the eastern Pacific, we see a 1005 millibar low pressure system. So as we head further out to Thursday the 14th of the month, we're seeing here that we have a pressure of 943 millibars. So that is likely a major hurricane about to make landfall in Mexico. And so GFS has it eventually making landfall. And of course, once it makes its way over land, it is going to rapidly weaken, because it is cut off from all that fuel that it was getting from the warm ocean waters. So eventually GFS has it emerging into the Gulf of Mexico as a very weak 1008 millibar low, but does not show much develop from there on. And now in terms of the Euro model, and so this is by Wednesday the 13th, and here we have Euro showing a pretty significant cyclone here, and by the 14th, Euro is showing that it is going to be making its way to the coast, definitely making that curve. But as we head to the 15th, rapid dissipation of the system is what Euro is showing here. So Euro is expecting that it is going to be making that curve, but not going to be emerging into the Gulf and redeveloping. So guys, again, things are quite early, and we have to wait and see what the eventual outcome is going to be in terms of our systems. But of course, I will keep you updated as time goes by. And so if you found this video to be quite informative, please give a thumbs up, and you can also share your thoughts with me in the comments or ask a question. I will try to respond as best and as soon as I can. And just remember to always be weather-wise.